Hi, I'm Michael Littman, and welcome to Clustering and Expectation Maximization. I don't know, it's a little drama might help kind of wake us up this morning. How you doing, Charles?
I'm doing fine. I just had a lot of ice cream.
Dude, you really shouldn't eat ice cream first thing in the morning.
It wasn't first thing in the morning. That was after I had a muffin and a breakfast burrito. So it was third thing in the morning.
You frightened me. As you may recall, the mini course that we're doing now is on unsupervised learning, and we haven't really kind of sat down and introduced these concepts. So I thought it might be worth taking a step back, even though we're going to talk about some particular algorithms today, to talk more generally about what unsupervised learning is. So up to this point, in the first mini course, we talked about supervised learning. In supervised learning, we use labeled training data to generalize labels to new instances. And what unsupervised learning is making sense out of unlabeled data. So when I wrote these down, I started to think, boy, they're more different than you'd expect just by sticking an un in front.
How so?
Well, the definitions don't seem to have all that much in common. You know, it's not like this one uses labeled training data to generalize labels to new instances, and this one uses unlabeled training data to generalize labels to new instances. Like, I would think that you'd have the definition of one, you just stick an extra un in there.
Well, that's kind of true, right? So if you do some data description and make sense out of unlabeled data, and then I give you a new piece of data, somehow using that description, you would know how to describe it.
Maybe. I mean, there's definitely some unsupervised learning algorithms that do some amount of generalization, mm-hmm. but it's not as unified. I think in some sense, the concern here is that unsupervised learning is just not as unified a problem or as well defined or crisply defined a problem as supervised learning is.
Oh, I think that's definitely true.
So just as labels, and I think we talked about this in the intro to the whole course, that supervised learning we can sometimes think of as function approximation, which is learning how to map inputs to outputs, whereas unsupervised learning is data description. It's about taking the data that you've got and finding some kind of more compact way of describing it.
Sure, I buy that, and that makes a lot of sense.